Hey Leo!
I hope you're doing fantastic. This is for singles and people who are separated or looking to see if there's any reconciliation possibility with their ex. So the first card you have, it's always going to be your position coming into the month. And you have the King of Cups. And this represents internal, external. The King of Cups is actually a good position to be in. This tells me that for singles, you're being very calm. You're not rushing into anything, you're looking at potential suitors, you're not, you know, looking for love at first sight. You're being very collected on this. You're listening, and you know, the King definitely listens, pays attention, makes rational decisions without jumping to conclusions. I get the feeling a lot of you are dating several people, maybe not dating several people, but you're meeting several people and having the potential to go on several dates, and you're just kind of feeling everything out. And some of you may have met one or two significant people that you think could be a good pairing for you, and you're going to, again, remain, and it's not emotionless, that's not a good word, because you have plenty of emotions, are great when it comes to, you know, their feelings and not hiding them, but you're kind of like not letting that rule. So you're not letting that love at first sight kind of come into play. Some of you are very excited about certain people you're meeting, but you're not, again, jumping into it, which tells me that a lot of you have been dating and it has not been successful. So you're taking a different approach. Like, hey, maybe I should read the red flags. Maybe I should listen to what they're actually telling me, because they might be telling me right here that they're a nutcase, or whatever, you know, it may be. For exes, or for people who are looking to see if reconciliation is here, this card is about counseling. So it's not that it's not there, that you're not ready, but there's definitely something that's raising flags saying you need counseling. Make sure you're not being manipulated, or that you're manipulating. Although I get the sense for a lot of you, there's some manipulation there and you're just not sure. So you're also acting kind of as a listener and very calm. You're wanting to see, because maybe this person that you've been with for a long time, you still care about them deeply. That's not the question. The question is, are they good for you? Have they treated you well? And you're starting to get the sneaking suspicion that maybe they've been manipulating you a little bit. Maybe that's why you separated, because maybe there were some lies, and not necessarily adultery or anything like that, but maybe some little white lies. And that makes you nervous, because little white lies can be good and can be bad. And little white lies turn into big lies sometimes. Or maybe they're a little too good at the little white lies, and that makes you nervous. Whatever it is, this is you definitely interested and wanting to see where it could go. And you're willing to listen to what they have to say. And you're willing to see counseling if that's what it takes, which could mean some of you were in some very serious relationships. But again, there's some sort of manipulation at play here, and you're just being very cautious. The next card you have is going to be the other person. So for singles, the person that you're potentially looking at, somebody who's coming in. And for exes, your ex, or people looking to reconcile your ex. So you have the Two of Wands. So this person is planning, and they have goals. So if you're single, this person is looking at you going, I think that they could have a lot of potential here. I feel like I could start planning third, fourth, fifth dates. Maybe we could even plan like a little, you know, getaway, maybe somewhere 2-3 hours down the road, a bed and breakfast, whatever. So this person's definitely interested in you. They want to see a little more of the emotional side. So if you're feeling it, it's a good time to start opening that up a little bit, letting yourself go, because this person does come across as being somebody, you know, pretty trustworthy. They just have a little more fire lit under them about it. And it's fine that you're not as it's not that you're not feeling as excited, you're just not presenting it that way, but eventually this person's going to want to be met with the same type of enthusiasm, because I sense that they're being a little more of the enthusiastic role when it comes to, you know, dating you. And it may be one or two people that you're dating, or maybe you've met one or two people that you've been kind of seeing, and you're not really dating so much. So this is one of those people, could be both of those people, but I get the general sense that if you're dating several people, you might have your eye locked on one person, and this is the person. If you're dating several people and you haven't met this person, this is the person you're striving to meet, and you will meet them. They're going to bring, some excitement out in you because they're going to be, not over the top, but they're just going to be happy and whimsical. For people looking to reconcile, this is your ex looking forward. So there's two ways that you can view, I mean, there's several ways you can view it, but two ways that stand out the most. Either they're looking forward and they're making goals and it's without you. So the counseling and listening and all of that, maybe they were manipulative and this is them, they're moving on to somebody else. But, and for some, I get the feeling that it's kind of like a half and half thing. So for some of you, that's exactly how they are. They're good. They're moving on because you decided you couldn't be manipulated and you're not going to be manipulated. For others of you, they're planning and looking forward with you. They're actually going, okay, let's go to counseling or let's do whatever. They just need to know from you that you're ready to move and that you do see some sort of reconciliation. And they're like, take it off, gung ho, let's get this on, let's move forward. And you're being more calm. We've been there, we've done this, and they're like, okay, well, let's set some goals, let's plan some things, but they still have a heat of passion for you. And you do too, but again, you're kind of staying behind that wall, which is not a bad thing. You have to do, whatever's going to be healthy for you. And some of you did feel like you were being manipulated. So, make sure you're taking care of yourself. This person's obviously fiery, and maybe they made you feel so good that you were overseeing things, or you were being manipulated, or feeling forced, or feeling kind of, lured into things that maybe weren't for you, or you didn't think were healthy in the relationship. So it's not a bad thing, but, pay attention. The next card you have is the potential. So this is a potential outcome for May, could go a little further, and this is, what looks to be the best outcome of the situation. So for singles, this is directness. So this is, you are being that kind of listener, calm. You're being very kingly of the King of Cups, and you're saying, now look, Two of Wands, I like you, or I think we should go on more dates. Or there's potential here, but this is what I need. And, I've been hurt before, or I have a good job, or I have kids, or I have things that I need to take care of. So I'm definitely down for fun, and I definitely want to get to know you better. But I have to be logical about this, and you have to know that it's not just all fun and games. And so the outcome for singles is, yes, there is great potential with this person or a few people that you've been dating, or if you haven't met them yet, you will. They're going to push you a little bit. They're going to push you into happy-go-lucky, and you're going to stand firm, and they're going to be okay with it. But they're going to still be able to get that smile out of you a little more often than you like. They're going to hit your vulnerable side a little more often than you'd like, but not in a bad way. It's going to bring you out of kind of a place you put yourself in of being responsible, making sure things happen, correctly. And for exes, people looking to reconcile, the outcome of this is not great. This is definitely confrontation, hostility. So again, like I said, there could be two ways. Could be that this person, they're planning, they're moving on, they're like, see ya, and now you're angry because you're gonna say, you know what? Screw you. Like, I gave you a lot of my time and I was good to you and you've manipulated me and you're easily moving on and now I see what it is. You're just somebody who moves from person to person to person. So there might be some confrontation or hostility because if they do move on, you're going to be feeling like, hey, like, what was this? This was just like some blip on your radar and, no, we need closure, and I need to find out what the heck is going on, and you know, did you take me for a ride? And if you are, if they are wanting to get back with you and you're wanting to get back with them, and they're planning and they're setting goals, there's still gonna be like a directness, kind of like with singles. There's gonna be like a logical directness. There's gonna be, you know, this is how it has to be going forward. And not that you're telling them it's my way or the highway or these are the rules. You're not like that. It's more none of these games or none of this, whatever it was you were going through. You know, I'm not gonna ask you know, to do things that you should generally do in a relationship, like make me feel secure because I make you feel secure, or you know, not flirt with men even though we're together, or women, or whatever the case is. This is definitely, you know, you guys coming together, but they're also understanding like this has to happen a certain way. And if you guys aren't willing to change, then you might as well just, you know, part ways and go your separate ways. Because if you guys don't make changes, and especially I see your partner as, or your ex as being the person who really needs to kind of get a grip on things or hone it in a little bit, if they don't do it, it's just going to lead to that hostility of the night. So definitely potential there, but I think whichever way it goes, Pisces, you're going to be fine because you're acting like the king. You're calm, cool, and collected. So it may hurt on the inside. And you may have to be a little more calm, cool, and collected than you want to. But I think if everything goes okay, then there is a lot of potential there. Regardless of singles and people looking to reconcile, there's good outcome as long as you keep your cool. And as long as they hone it in, then I think it's good for both of you.